show to finally begin.
But first, a few reminders.
No eating, drinking, or smoking at any time inside the theater. That's like totally uncool.
Yeah, and at this time, please silence all electronic devices so they don't make any noise during your reverent sermon.
Oh, and make sure that your stylish face covering stays on your nose and mouth the entire show, unless you're actively drinking. You don't want Principal Clark to keep his attention.
It's been way too long since we've been in the theater altogether. Right, ready, Jack?
So that means during the show, be as loud and vocal as you want, so we all have a rad time. We're not in a library.
You said it. Tonight's performance is conducted by Alice Parrish. Now, sit back, relax, and enjoy.
The Monarchs and Monarchs proudly presents Footloose.
Thank you. we sing, but we lift our voices to tell the world who we are and what we believe in. So I ask you this morning, what song are you singing?
Won't you join us, Mrs. McCormick? Eleanor wants to show us what heaven tastes like. Call the apple.
planning to introduce something vulgar, modern novel to our American liquors?
Slaughterhouse-Five. Yes, Coach, I received several calls.
Wait, Slaughterhouse-Five? Now that's one cool story and cool book. Cover it, cover it! Slaughterhouse-Five! Oh, Slaughterhouse-Five! Right, no, that's a classic.
Do you read much?
Oh, Coach, maybe in another town it's a classic.
No, any town, it's Slaughterhouse-Five.
Tom Sawyer is a classic.
Daddy! Daddy! Daddy, Rusty and the girls are going out for burgers tonight. Can I?
Tomorrow is a school thing.
Oh, Daddy!
That's your mother.
Oh, we went to dinner every morning, and she said that if it was good with you, then it was good with her. So, do we get you? Daddy, come on! Great sermon, Reverend!
Thank you, Rusty.
Oh, and I'll bring you some about what women and rock and roll and listen to music and the soul and all that. I mean, I was like, hey, Dad!
I praise indeed, gentlemen.
I, on the other hand, thought my daddy was never going to shut up.
Ariel, why don't you just talk to him?
Why? He never listens to me. And anyways, I... Welcome to Beaumont.
Howdy.
Yesterday, with her 86 looks barely
Your mother thought you might be cool.
Evening, Reverend.
Thank you.
It's a chance to look.
Oh,
shut up! Miss May.
Red is very sorry for his actions. He was ignorant of our local law, and I will inform him of his ignorance. Mm-hmm.
And I will see both of you in my office after school.
Oh.
your guests in your home.
Erica!
Right now, just don't say anything.
Never laugh too loud, never leave a crowd, never dress risky, never be hailed. If you've ever had anything to hide, think twice before you step outside. Step outside, somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are following every move. Somebody's waiting to show they don't. Please.
Can he really compete? Chuck Cranston, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout slash drug dealer who was recently evicted from a trailer park.
Oh, that's right. Right.
I don't
that's
think right. so.
Come on, quit dodging the question. What's the deal with you and Rusty?
Beats me. I think she's good looking and all, but I never know what the hell she's talking about. She talks faster than any girl I ever met.
It's because you make her horny.
You think?
If only I could find a guy who would make the first move. If only I could find a guy who, when he went to kiss me at night, would take the toothpick out of his mouth.
That's nice.
If only I could find a guy. Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods? Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising tide?
I'd like to know
in the white night upon the fiery steed. Late at night I toss and I turn.
I toss and I turn.
Don't tell me to calm down! Don't ever tell me what to do!
I know what your friends say to me. And that's bullshit. I'm the best party in town, baby. And those three dogs ought to be tied up under the bush. Let's go.
No!
Get in the trunk.
No!
Excuse me?
I said no, what part of that don't you understand?
When the preacher's daughter says no, it just makes me hot. Say it again.
The
lady said no.
And I believe this is none of your business. Ariel, who invited this clown?
I'm sorry, we have been wrongly introduced.
Red McCormick!
Get your hand out of my face and your face out of my face.
Shut up, you want to fight? That's part of it.
Like what?
tell it to the train. I do.
Thank you. that come from?
From you, Daddy. Today's sermon is the world is evil and Ariel is to be locked away in a tower.
That's a little melodramatic, isn't it?
No, it's not. Daddy, you make me feel like a prisoner. And I hate it. I just hate it.
Someone's gonna put a foot down.
I didn't say anything.
I don't enjoy being her jailer. I don't relish telling her no. But then I think, what if I fail her? How can I just let her go? I strive to be a preacher. I try to go for her. Then I think, if I can reach her, how can I face my Lord?
Two!
Hey, maybe we gotta take the coach dancing.
What? What do you think?
What? That's it? We're gonna throw a dance.
What?
We're gonna throw a kick-ass party! Then I'll stole one right off its tractors!
We're just asking for a fight.
Hey, bring it on!
You ready to take on Rivermore?
I'll take a minute.
What about the town council?
I'll fight City Hall! Look, if there's one thing we're fighting for, it's freedom!
Looking in the if there's anything worth it, it's worth the fight.
dumb shit. We're not in the water, so we can do some tail shaking.
Look at him!
I was just over there, and Wendy Jo said she left hours ago with Russell.
Oh.
Who is it?
Mr. Cranston. Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
Isn't it a bit late, Mr. Cranston?
Yes, sir. That's why I'm surprised she's not at home.
Good night, Mr. Cranston. Please remember, next time, we have a front door guest.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Jo's. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
Did you know this?
No, I did not.
So how does it feel by now that she's lying?
I'm not saying anything until I've heard an explanation from her.
It's frightening enough when she was running around with Chuck Cranston. Now she's out in the middle of the night and that Funko's campaign needs to challenge me at the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Where are we?
Harry!
Oh, Rusty and Wendy Jo and me, we were... No, we weren't at Wendy Jo's.
I can't believe you're checking up on me!
Sweet, how are we supposed to know?
We are concerned for your well-being!
Well, then how come when I'm at home, you're never interested in what I'm thinking or how I feel? The second I walk out that door, wham! Suddenly you're the concerned parent.
She doesn't...
Stop defending her! She has her answer for herself!
I don't know what good that would do.
Stopped.
that you're going to be speaking to the town council. So don't move. Now try that last part one more time.
Members of the town council, dancing is not a crime.
Yeah?
Ever since the dawn of time, if anything, everybody had the right to howl at the moon and to boo all night. When folks were tribal, back before the Bible, they were liable to dance when the crops came in. Or they'd blow out stalks so the earth would spin. Or maybe they had a battle to win, so they would dance. Every time they had a chance, no matter the reason or circumstance, they found a reason to throw a whole party in their pants. So let's do what I did. And just dance. Dance. Dance.
You said party in your pants? Guys, Brandon, we're not saying the speech is bad. It's just not good.
What am I supposed to do? I've rewritten it 9 times.
You're going to be speaking to Reverend Lauren, some of the most stubborn people in this town.
You've already got plenty of them just boiling mad.
Yeah, folks are picking sides and they're not picking yours.
Well, then who am I kidding? Look, this has gotten way out of me. Maybe I ought to just forget it.
Whoa there, little bunny. We don't mean to discourage you.
After all the signs we've painted?
All the flyers we passed out? Everyone at school's climbing the walls. Hang in there. You just gotta rethink your approach. Now, Mama says,
oh, not Mama.
Now, hold on just 1 minute. Everything I ever learned that gets me through the worst, I learned at my mama's knee.
Just means you're ready to fly. And Mama says it doesn't matter if you try.
by a chandelier. Unless you got a ceiling.
Thank you.
My scared a little. Mm-hmm.
Really should.
Since the beginning of time, people dance for many reasons. They dance so that their crops will be plentiful, so that their hope will be good. Yeah. They dance to show community spirit.
Amen.
They dance to celebrate life. And that's the kind of dancing we're talking
about. Mr. McCormick, we don't
get it. So, excuse me, brother. Aren't we told in Psalm 149 to praise the Lord? To sing unto him a new song.
Amen.
Let them praise his name in dance.
Yes.
And it was King David who we learned about in Samuel.
Yep.
And what did David do? What did David do?
Oh! realize I hadn't been doing that. After all, we all remember that terrible night 5 years ago on the 20 Bridge, the lives of four young people ended. Everyone in this community lost someone, a child, a neighbor,
thank you. Yeah.